हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू नागेश करसगी ऑर्किड स्कूल चैनल। माय सेल्फ प्रिया टीचर एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू साइंस सब्जेक्ट फॉर क्लास 7। सो चिल्ड्रन, वी स्टार्टेड अवर लेसन नंबर 10। ओके, सो व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ अवर लेसन नंबर 10? इट इज अ रेस्पिरेशन इन ऑर्गेनिजम्स। ओके, सो वी स्टार्टेड लेसन नंबर 10, रेस्पिरेशन इन ऑर्गेनिजम्स। सो कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट इज मीन बाय रेस्पिरेशन? ओके, यस, वेरी गुड। सो व्हाट इज मीन बाय रेस्पिरेशन? रेस्पिरेशन इज द प्रोसेस इन विच ग्लूकोज इज ब्रोकन डाउन इन टू कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, वाटर एंड एनर्जी। सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अ रेस्पिरेशन। एंड व्हाट इज विच आर द टाइप्स ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन? यस, वेरी गुड, एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन एंड एनरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन, करेक्ट। सो वी वेर डिस्कसिंग अवर ह्यूमन रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम। The human respiratory system. So we discussed how human respiratory system can work. So again here it is given the picture of human respiratory system. In human respiratory system, these are nostrils, this is nasal passage, this is a trachea, and these are the bronchies, and this is lungs are going to surrounded by that structure, it is called as a ribs. Okay, so we discussed that whenever there is inhalation and exhalation, okay, like this. So mechanism of breathing we discussed last session. So exhalation is given here and inhalation is also given here. So here you can see in this first picture it is given exhalation. So this is the diaphragm, this is a pink colored structure which is a muscular sheet, that is a diaphragm. So this diaphragm, you can see it moves upward. Okay, so little bit curve is there, you can see at the upper side of this chest cavity. So this is nothing but the chest cavity with the lungs and this rib cage. This is a chest cavity, and at the below side of this chest cavity, here it is a muscular sheet which is called as a diaphragm. So this diaphragm, you can see little bit it is moved upward. Okay, so this moving upward process of this diaphragm, or moving upward position of this diaphragm, what happens with this, because of this, so this exhalation process is going to happen here. So whenever this diaphragm is going to move upward, so whatever air is absorbed or which is taken in by our body or by the nostrils, that air is going to give out from our nose again. So that is called as a exhalation. And again our nostrils are going to take in air and it is going to pass to our lungs. But when it will happen? When this diaphragm is going to move again downward. So this is the position of this diaphragm, which is a not contracted or not relaxed and not moving upward and not moving downward. So when it will it is going to move, see here it is moving upward, but when it is going to move downward, that time air is going to taken in through the nostrils and it is going to pass to the lungs. So this is called as a inhalation. So again in this picture, again it is shown that this is a position of diaphragm which is moved upward, so that time exhalation can done here, and here that diaphragm is going to again move downward, that is called as a inhalation. Okay, so this is a mechanism of breathing. Let us see a video which will explain you how breathing mechanism of human being will done with our respiratory system.
Let us now understand how breathing occurs in human beings. First, we inhale air through our nostrils. This this inhaled air passes into the nasal cavity. Here, the air is filtered and heated. From the nasal cavity, the inhaled air passes down the throat and enters the windpipe known as trachea. From the trachea, it reaches both our lungs, which are present in the chest cavity. This cavity is surrounded by ribs on both sides. These ribs form a cage-like structure called the rib cage. A large muscular sheath called the diaphragm forms the door of the chest cavity. The rib cage and the diaphragm show movements during inhalation and exhalation. Once the inhaled air reaches the lungs, it enters tiny air sacs known as alveoli inside the lungs. Here in the alveoli, gas exchange takes place, that is, oxygen is exchanged for carbon dioxide. The oxygen in the alveoli travels into the bloodstream and is used up in cellular respiration. The carbon dioxide in the blood moves into the alveoli and is expelled out of the human body through exhalation.
Okay, so hope student you understood what exactly mechanism of breathing in human beings. So let us move to our next point. Which is respiration in other animals. So these are some activities. These activities we will discuss in our next session. First we will discuss what is the respiration or which type of respiration is there in other animals. So now we discussed about human beings, but how exactly with other animals this respiration process occurs or is done in their body, we will see in our next point, which is a breathing in other animals. So first we will discuss it is a cockroach. So cockroach breathes through small openings in their body called spiracles. So first animal we will discuss here, which is a cockroach. Okay, so you saw cockroach. Nowadays you can see in your kitchen there are so many cockroaches will come out when you will off your off light at night from your kitchen. Okay, so after some time you have to go, after 5 minutes, 10 minutes you have to go, then what will you will see when you will on light, you will see that many cockroaches are coming out and they are moving here and there. So these cockroach, how they breathe? Okay, so let us know. So cockroach breathes through small openings in their body called spiracles. So what is the spiracles here? So this is the nothing but the internal structure is shown here of cockroach in this picture. Okay, and here it is a structure which is only showing the main parts of the respiratory system of cockroach. So here the part of the cockroach which is a mouth part, or this is a head region. You cannot identify now which part is there at this side, left or right, up and down. So this is the internal structure shown here. So here it is the head region, then this is the trunk region, and you can see the anus region here, this side, okay, or the end part of this cockroach body structure here you can see. So whenever we are going to take a section of cockroach body structure, then what you can see here, this type of structure you will see in this LS or whatever it is structure you are going to see internally. So first we will see where it is a spiracles. So spiracles are first abdominal spiracle is shown here. Okay, so these are the first abdominal spiracles. Then the spiracles are connected to air tubes. So these spiracles are connected to the air tubes. So here you can see these are the air sacs are shown here. This is the structure which is known as air sac. This is the air sacs, and whatever tubes are there which are going to join these air sacs with the spiracle, these are called as a air tubes. Okay, so here you can see the thoracic air sacs. These are the thoracic air sacs. These are the thoracic spiracles which are going to open into the thoracic air sacs. These spiracles are called as the thoracic spiracles. Then first abdominal spiracle, when there is an abdominal part and these abdominal spiracles, it means whenever there is opening of the spiracles into the abdominal air sacs, so that is called as a abdominal spiracle. So from here abdominal structure is going to start. That is why it is shown here the first abdominal spiracle. Then at the end also you can see this is the, from this region and from this, it is a abdominal part of cockroach. So from first to end, these are having spiracles, or this is a abdominal sacs also you can see here. So this is a trunk of cockroach. So the spiracles are connected to the air tubes called trachea. So here you can see the trachea structure also. So ventral tracheal trunk here. So dorsal tracheal. So ventral, it means at the lower side or the ground surface, at the ground surface. And dorsal, it means whatever part of that cockroach towards the sky, it is called as a dorsal one. So ventral and dorsal like this. Or also we can say that part which is towards at the side of stomach, which at which side, that is called as a ventral. And whenever there is a back position of our body, that is called as a dorsal here. So here you can see the tracheal, lateral, it means whatever side part, left side or right side of our body, that is the lateral part. Okay, so these lateral tracheal are also there, then dorsal tracheal trunk is also there, and ventral tracheal trunk is also there. So these spiracles are connected to the air tubes which are called as a trachea. Okay, then oxygen rich air enters through the spiracles and passes through the trachea to all cells in the body. So when air is going to taken in by these cockroaches, what happens? These cockroaches are going to pass this oxygen rich air through these spiracles, and these are going to pass through the trachea to the cells in the body. So whatever cells are there present in this cockroach body structure, these cells are going to get air from these spiracles and then through the trachea, and then last point, it is a cells. So carbon dioxide from the cells passes through the trachea and spiracles out of the body. Again, this oxygen, carbon dioxide, it means after respiration process, whatever carbon dioxide is released, then that carbon dioxide is going to exhale, or it is going to pass through the trachea and spiracles out of the body. It is going to exhale by the trachea and spiracles again. So here in this structure you can see the spiracles. So clearly you can see the which type of structures these spiracles are having here. Okay, and this is the tracheal trunk. So this structure, which is a little bit rectangular structure, it is nothing but the tracheal trunks. And these spiracles are going to pass air first into the tracheal trunk, and these tracheas are going to pass that air into the cells of this cockroach. Okay, so this is a respiratory system of cockroach. Then next, earthworm. So how earthworm respire? So earthworms breathe through their moist skin. So these are not having any respiratory system there. So how they can respire? So earthworms breathe through their moist skin. So this you saw earthworms nowadays, you can easily saw when you will dig a little bit soil from your garden of your home, at your home, or from if you will go in farm and if you will dig some soil, then you can see earthworms will come out from this soil, from that soil. Okay, so these earthworms are little bit having little bit moist skin. So earthworms breathe out their moist skin. The moist skin helps in the exchange of gases. So because of this moist skin, what happens? These earthworms can exchange gases. It means whatever gas is necessary for the inhaling, and that it is going to absorb by this skin, and whatever gas it is going to exhale or going to given out from their body, it is done with this moist skin again. Okay, so you know, for living organisms and animals, most of the time oxygen is inhaled or absorbed and carbon dioxide it is released. So here also it happens same. Then next animal, it is fish. So fishes breathe through gills. The gills have blood vessels which help in the exchange of gases. So in fish, you know, fish are living in water only. So these are aquatic living organisms. So these living organisms, how can they respire? Okay, so they cannot get air easily. Okay, you think that these living organisms are living in water, so it is very difficult to absorb or to inhale or take in air from the atmosphere. But we don't need to care about this, because why? Because these fish are having particular type of structure which is called as a gills. So with these gills, what they can do? The gills have blood vessels which help in the exchange of gases. So these gills are attached with blood vessels, and which can help them to exchange the gases. So that is why no need to worry, they can also easily respire in water also. So here you can see in this picture, water flows through mouth. So how they are taking air? So because they cannot come out of the water and take in air, so though they are living in water, they have to, or they are taking in water. Okay, and whatever air is present in air, so in our previous class we learn about that where there is a presence of oxygen in water also, how it is present in air also, how it is present, and these activities also you done in our previous class. Okay, so to prove this thing that oxygen is present there in a water, so whatever oxygen they want to absorb, that oxygen it can be absorbed by this water only. So for that they should have to take in water first. So how they are going to take in water? So they are going to take in water through their mouth. And whenever they are going to take in water through the mouth, here you can see the gill structure. Okay, the part gill, which is very important for the respiration of fish. So from these gills, some blood vessels are attached with these gills, and by these gills what they are going to do? So they are going to absorb, the water flows over the gills then out. So from these gills, mouth, the water is going to take in, and from these gills water is going to out, in exhale out, okay, or given out. So before giving out this water, these gills are going to absorb oxygen and then they can give out the water. So like this fish can breathe. Okay, then respiration in plants. So plants also take in oxygen from air and give out carbon dioxide. So this oxygen is used in the cells to break down glucose into carbon dioxide and water and release energy. So in our first lesson we discussed this. The plants can take oxygen from the air, take in oxygen from the air and give out carbon dioxide. This oxygen is used in the cells to break down the glucose into the carbon dioxide and water and energy. The leaves have tiny pores called stomata. So we know that these are the stomatas which are present on the leaf. Okay, so these stomatas are going to exchange gases. So whatever oxygen is released, whatever oxygen is taken in, whatever CO2 is released, whatever CO2 is taken in, these all gases are exchanged because of these stomata, okay, which is a part of leaf. And the root hair also help to take air from the soil, and here you can see the root hairs. So these root hairs are also going to take in air from the soil, and again they are going to absorb oxygen whenever they are going to need oxygen. But we know at the daytime which gas is absorbed by the plants. Correct. So CO2 is absorbed by the plants at the daytime. But what happens at night? So at night these plants are going to absorb oxygen and they are going to release carbon dioxide. So that is why our grandparents told us, or our parents told us that whenever there is a night time, we should not have to take sleep or not to sit under the trees, because at night these plants are going to release CO2 and it will be harmful to our body. That is why we don't have to sit at night under trees or near to the plants. Okay, so this is a respiration in plants. So what we learn today, we will see through this video.
Breathing and breathing fluid. Breathing oxygen for various body activities. Example, energy production in cell. We obtain oxygen from the air around us with the help of nose and lungs. It is then used in the cells to produce energy. The process of taking oxygen-rich air inside the body is called inhalation. And the process of throwing air rich in carbon dioxide outside the body is called exhalation. Together, inhalation and exhalation is called breathing. Let's now understand how breathing takes place. Air enters in the body through openings of the nose called nostrils. It flows through nasal cavity, enters the rib cage, and then gets filled in the lungs. This is inhalation. During inhalation, the muscular sheath called diaphragm situated below lungs undergo contraction, due to which the diaphragm moves downwards and becomes flat. It causes increase in the chest cavity. With this movement, the pressure of air outside the body becomes larger than the pressure of air present in the lungs. To equalize the pressure, air rushes into the lungs. After the absorption of oxygen from air into blood and release of carbon dioxide from blood into the lungs, the exhalation begins. During exhalation, the diaphragm relaxes. It moves up and decreases the chest cavity, due to which lungs get contracted, due to which pressure of air inside the lungs becomes greater than the pressure of air outside the body. To equalize the pressure now, the excess air gets rushed out of the body through nostrils. This is called exhalation. One inhalation and one exhalation. The number of times a person breathes during a wedding is called as breathing pain. So breathing pain
See, so what is mean by breathe? So breathe is equal to one inhalation plus one exhalation. It means whenever you are going to take in air, that is called as an inhalation. So whenever you are going to take in air at a one time, it is called as a one inhalation. Okay, and when you are going to give out air, it means at a one time, whenever you are going to give out air, that is called as a one exhalation. So see this concept carefully. If I think you will get confused. So how many times? It means 2-3 times or 2-3 times exhalation and inhalation. So not it is. So breathe, one breathe, it means whenever you are going to take air at a one time, take in air at a one time, and after that at a one time when you are going to exhale air. So that is why it is given here like breathe is equal to one inhalation plus one exhalation, that is called as a one breathe. So try to understand this concept properly. Then the number of times of a person breathe during a minute is called the his breathing rate. So whenever you are going to breathe, it is a one inhalation and one exhalation. But whenever you are going to know about breathing rate, so at that time in a minute, it means for in a 60 seconds, so in a 60 seconds how many times you are going to take in air and how many time you are going to give out air, that is called as a breathing rate. Or in short we can say in a minute how many times you are going to breathe, it is called as a breathing rate.
When someone needs oxygen, which in turn depends on need of energy. Example, during running or in excessive movements, we need more energy and hence need more oxygen. To obtain more oxygen, we breathe at higher rate. However, when we are relaxed or sleeping, we need little amount of energy. And therefore, putting a lot of oxygen is needed. In such condition, the breathing rate is slow. On an average, a normal human body is breathing at a rate of 12 to 18 beats per minute. During heavy movements, it may increase up to 25 beats per minute. But in a relaxed state, it can go down to 12 beats per minute.
Okay, so see whenever there is a breathing rate is going to be faster, that time what happens? So we are going to get more energy. It means whenever our body is needed more energy, that time we should have to get more oxygen. And when we try to get more oxygen, that time our breathing rate is going to also increase. Okay. So when more energy, more oxygen and more breathing rate or faster breathing rate we can say. So in this video or in this picture you can see one boy is doing exercise here. So at the time of exercise more energy is needed, that is why more oxygen is needed, and that is why breathing rate of this boy we can see it is faster. And while this boy is going to sleep, that time amount of oxygen is not needed more or energy is needed less. That is why amount of oxygen it is also needed less and breathing rate is also going to be low or it is going to decrease. So scientist found that average breathing rate. So whenever there is an average breathing rate, so in a minute a normal person can breathe 12 to 18 times, or it can take 12 to 18 breaths in a minute. So whenever there is a normal person, so it should have to be 12 to 18 breaths in a minute. Then breathing rate during the heavy movements. So heavy movements, what it means? So when you are going to climb somewhere, or you are going to jump, you are going to run, you are going to walk fast or do exercise, that is called as a heavy movement. So at that time 25 breaths for in a minute you can see. So breathing rate it is 25 breaths in a minute. Then breathing rate during the relaxed state it means while you are sleeping or while you are sitting only on chair or on ground at your home. So at that time breathing rate it will be 12 breaths per minute. It is a very normal. It can be seen in only normal person. And whenever there is a no normal person or abnormal things are going to happen there, you cannot see this type of rate. So nowadays, you know, we are going through a pandemic situation. So what happens with us? So every day we are going to check our temperature, and also we are checking our oxygen level, okay, with oximeter. So why we are going to check? Because is our lungs or our throat or our body is infected with COVID-19 or not infected with COVID-19. For this purpose we are checking our oxygen level also. So whenever there is oxygen level, that time oxygen level will low, that is it means our body is going to infect or infected. So that is why breath rate is also important here. So whenever there is oxygen level is lower, what will happen with this breath? So our body is going to breathe fast, okay? So breathing rate is also going to be faster. So whenever there is a COVID patient, you can see that breathing in these persons, it is faster. They cannot breathe properly and they need more oxygen, they need more energy, and that is why their breathing rate is going to be faster. But if their body is not going to perform properly that time. So
addition to breathing, during excessive movements, we also take deep breaths so as to get more oxygen during each breath. So I hope you understood the story very well. Thanks for watching this video. For more videos, love
them. Okay children, so we discussed about some organisms in our today's lesson, respiration in organisms, okay. But remaining some other living organisms are also there, or some other animals are also there, which we not discussed today. So these animals we will discuss in our next session. Today we will stop here. Hope whatever we discussed in our today's session, you understood properly what we discussed here. So breathing rate, inhalation, exhalation, and some types of respiration in different animals. So remaining part we will discuss in our next session. We will stop here. Thank you.